Okay, so let's look at common gate low frequency response. Common gate configuration looks like this. So this is your input voltage, source resistance, the source resistance R, then CS, then drain gate source. RD is the resistance, RL is the resistance, CD is the capacitor, VDD, V0. So we are giving input to the source and taking output from the drain. So that's why gate is common. Then you can see there are two capacitors, so we have to calculate two FLs, FL1, FL2, corresponding to CS and CD, and then maximum of whichever one FL is maximum, we'll take the FL that one. Okay, so FL will be maximum of the two FLs what we'll calculate corresponding to CS and CD. Okay, so first we will calculate RTH1 corresponding to CS. So this will be the circuit which will look like if you will represent with a small signal equivalent. So gate is ground, VGS, source GMVGS, R0, drain. So this is gate, this is source, this is drain. Then you can see RD parallel RL. These two I have taken together, RD parallel RL, that is RL dash, and this capacitor is short. Okay. Here I have taken V in short, R is as it is. Now we have to look from CS, the RTH. So I have connected VX and IX. Okay. So VX I have connected in this fashion. You can take it in any fashion. IX is the current flowing through this branch. So IX will be current flowing through this branch as well. And in this branch it will flow IX plus GMVGS because of this guy. So if you apply KVL in this loop from ground R, VX, R0, RL dash, you will get VX is equal to RIX plus R0 IX plus R0 GMVGS plus IX RL dash. You can see the equation is dependent upon VX and IX, but you have to remove this VGS. So for that, apply KVL in the input loop. You will get VGS plus VX minus IX RS, VGS plus VX plus IS, minus IX RS, because current is in this direction, you are going in this direction. Okay. So VGS will be equal to IXR minus VX. You plug the value of VGS here, you will get VX is equal to RIX plus R0 IX plus R0 GM IXR minus R0 GM VX plus IX RL dash. You can see the equation is dependent upon IX and VX. You do VX divided by IX, that is RTH1 will be equal to R plus R0 plus R0 GM R plus RL dash divided by 1 plus GM R0. This will be your RTH1. Okay. If you will plug R0 is equal to infinite, what you will get? RTH1 is equal to 1 plus GMR divided by GM. R0 is equal to infinite means these two terms will be remain, and rest two terms will be cancelled. In the denominator only GM will be there. Okay. So this you can approximate it with GMR divided by GM. GM GM gets cancelled. So RTH1 become approximately equal to R. Okay. So if R0 will be infinite, RTH1 will be approximately equal to R, or you can see RTH1 will be equal to 1 plus GMR divided by GM. Okay, but the generalized expression for RTH1 will be this one. Okay, once you have the value of RTH1, you can calculate the FL1. FL1 will be 1 by 2 pi RTH1 CS. Okay, so this will be FL1. Now we will calculate the FL2 corresponding to CD. Okay, corresponding to CD. Okay, let's calculate RTH2 now. Okay, so RTH2 will be corresponding to CD. So this will be the circuit. So VX, IX I have placed here at the position of CD. This is short, this CS. VI is short. Rest of the circuit is as it is. Now I have assumed current I1 and I2 in this branch and this branch. So this current will be from R0, it is I2 minus GM VGS. Again here at from R it will be I2. Okay, and from RD it is flowing I1. Total current is IX. Okay, so first if you will apply KVL here, you will get VGS is equal to minus R I2. And if you will apply KCL here, you will get Ix is equal to I1 plus I2. Then you apply KVL at this branch, so ground RD R0 R. You will get minus RD R1, minus RD I1 plus I2 R0 minus GM VGS R0 plus R I2 is equal to 0. Okay, so this will be the KVL equation. If you will place the value of VGS from here to here, that is, if you will plug the value of VGS from here to here, you will get minus RD I1 plus I2 R0 plus GM R I2 R0 plus R I2 is equal to 0. If you club the value of I2 and I1 together, you will get R plus R0 plus GM R R0 I2 is equal to RD I1. Okay, so this is dependent upon I2 and I1, you can see. Now plug the value of I2 here at this equation, you will get equation in terms of I1 and Ix. So you can see here I1 plus RD I1 divided by R plus R0 plus GM R R0 is equal to Ix. So you can write the equation in terms of I1 and Ix. So you will get R plus R0 plus GM R R0 divided by R plus RD plus R0 plus GM R R0 into Ix. Okay, so this we have got I1 in terms of Ix. Now if you will see the draw, if you will apply KVL here in this loop, you will get Vx is equal to RD I1 plus RL Ix. If you plug the value of I1 here from here to here, you will get Vx equation in terms of Vx and Ix. Okay, so if you will do Vx divided by Ix is equal to RD into R plus R0 plus GM R R0 divided by R plus RD plus R0 plus GM R R0 plus RL. This is not in denominator. Okay, this is separate. So that this will be the RTH2. Okay. Now, if you will plug the value of R0 is equal to infinite, if R0 is equal to infinite, then what will happen? RTH2 will be RD into R0. R0 will get cancel 1 plus GM R divided by 1 plus GM R. Okay, these two terms will be remaining plus RL. So this will get cancelled. So you will get RD plus RL. Okay, RTH2 when R0 is infinite. Okay, so this is easier to remember, but this is generalized expression. Okay, when R0 is not infinite. So this this is the RTH2. Now once you have RTH2, FL2 will be 1 divided by 2 pi RTH2 CD. Okay, which is with respect to common drain. And once you have the value of FL2, you can select the FL, that is FL is equal to maximum of FL1 comma FL2. Okay, and you can write low frequency gain will be magnitude of A mid divided by under root 1 plus FL divided by F whole square. Okay, so for any frequency you can calculate the low frequency response for common gate. Okay, midband gain we have already calculated. Okay, you can just copy paste from the previous videos. Okay, and FL is maximum of these two. Okay, so that was the low frequency response of common gate.